Hello and welcome to the Slingshot Channel. Today we're going to do a cool experiment with rubber, what else? But no shooting.
I just came back from California, and at an event I visited, I saw a speech by Derek Müller. Dr. Müller actually has a very, very famous YouTube channel. It's called Veritasium. I encourage you to take a look if you don't know it already. He is doing all kinds of cool physics experiments. And one of the things that he showed us was a slinky in slow motion. He just held up the slinky and then released it, and then he filmed what happens. And I found it really cool, and therefore I decided to test if it's working the same way with rubber. So here is a piece of steel. It's actually 800 grams heavy, real heavy piece of solid steel, painted bright yellow for visibility. And I attached a very thin rubber strip to it, really thin. And the question is, if I let it hanging like this and release it, what is going to happen? And Derek always says, now take a guess. Now take 3 seconds and guess what happens. Will, when I release it, will this start falling first, or will they snap together? What's going to happen? What do you think? All right, let's test it. And we're going to film this in 1,000 frames per second to see what's happening. All right, here we go. Wasn't that really amazing? I mean, who would have thought that this hangs still in air, suspended, until the rubber is completely relaxed and actually snaps right onto the iron bar? You can only really see this well in slow motion. And Dr. Müller's slinky behaved the same way, except that rubber is, of course, compressing much more violently. This means that it snaps back far faster than the slinky. And I think it looks even cooler that way. Since we have enough rubber, it's a fairly long band, let's test this from a higher position and see if it also functions if we let it hang like 3 or 3.5 meters. Okay, here we go. It still works, obviously. Interesting, fascinating. And now let's test it in comparison with a weight that hangs suspended on a piece of string. This is our test candidate. Same material, same weight, same everything, but a different color. And it hangs on this nice yellow string. And as you see, this does not give, as a difference to the rubber, that of course is really, really flexible. Okay, let's go.
So in the slow motion, you can clearly see that the blue one starts falling earlier. And as it accelerates by gravity, you see that the difference becomes more and more clear.
Very interesting. I think it was clear that the effect was much less strong on the string. There was obviously a little bit of elastic effect in that too. But it started to fall almost immediately. Whereas this one hangs suspended in air before it starts falling. So why is that? What is the physical explanation? Well, Dr. Müller explains it in one of his videos that if you release it, it takes some time until the object notices it's no longer attached. And only after that happens, it starts to fall. So even if I release this here, it takes a short moment, depending on how elastic that is. On this one, it's almost instantaneous. And on this one, it just takes until the rubber has fully retracted again before it starts falling. So I hope you like this, because that's it for today. Thanks and bye bye.